Now we are on our psychological first aid or counseling for sexual assault survivors. That you have to deal very first. You have to handle the patient with these aspects. How psychological counseling is done and how can any doctor do it if psychologist or psychiatrist is not available. Any male, female, transgender, any age range with disability, without disability, one can predict with whom it's going to happen. It can happen to anyone. Are exposed to a different traumatic event ranging from physical, emotional and sexual abuse to natural disaster. This put them at an increased risk of psychiatric disorder and other problems. Trauma leaves major impact on mind. So we have to deal with the mind and we have to counsel them throughout, right? So how this mind works? It works with the cognitive, affective and connective. मतलब आपकी सोचने समझने की क्षमता के साथ, your emotions and आपकी व्यवहार करने की तरीके में. कभी कभी इतना दुख हो जाता है कि सेल्फ हार्म करने की इट्स अ लास्ट ऑप्शन फॉर समवन, राइट? सो वी हैव टू डील विद ऑल दीज एस्पेक्ट. कभी ओरिएंटेशन नहीं रहता, अटेंशन, कंसंट्रेशन, मेमोरी लॉस, कुछ भी हो सकता है. पता ही नहीं है वो कौन है, कहाँ पर है, आजू बाजू में लोग कहाँ. द ट्रामा कैन लीड दैट इम्पैक्ट टू एन इंडिविजुअल. सो वी हैव टू डील विद ऑल दीज थिंग्स फर्दर. First aid. Because when the patient will come to you, that survivor will be in shock condition. जब आपको survivor के साथ deal करना है, that individual into a shock most of the time. And then it will be a denial. The next step, जब वो shock से बाहर निकलेंगे, it will be denial. Then anger. Then sadness. कि क्या हुआ? Anger will be on ourselves or with others. क्यों भेजा, क्या हुआ, what all might be there. Then detachment even from light. Then again, time heals things. Reorganization, then adaptation. But we have to ready for ourselves to treat a person when someone is in shock. What happens, fear and shock, these are the psychological health consequences. Emotional pain, physical pain, intense self-disgust, powerlessness, worthlessness, apathy, denial, numbing, withdrawal and inability to function normally in their lives. Why need to emphasize of psychological first aid? Because trauma hampered overall well-being of an individual. What will be the difficulties in emergency management, difficulties in assessing, difficulty in rapport building, tendency to withhold information, they will not reveal you everything. Different presentation of psychological issues. So for what we do it is a psychological first aid. The first is preparedness. We have to prepare. कि अगर हमारे पास कोई survivor इस condition में आता है, what we have to do? It should not be like that कि we are managing the kid at that moment. We are searching for the performer. We are searching for the manual कि हमें क्या करना है. वी बिकम पैनिक कि हम क्या देख रहे हैं, राइट? सो यू मतलब बी इन रिक्वायर्ड अ प्रिपेयर्डनेस देन रिस्पॉन्सेस फेज एंड देन रिकवरी फेज. कॉन्टैक्ट एंड एंगेजमेंट, सेफ्टी, कम्फर्ट, स्टेबिलाईजिंग, प्रोसेसिंग इन्फॉर्मेशन गैदरिंग, प्रैक्टिकल असिस्टेंस, कनेक्शन विद सोशल सपोर्ट, दैट विल बी इन अ रिकवरी फेज, इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन कोपिंग, लिंकेज विद कोलैबोरेटिव सर्विसेज. प्रिपेयर, लर्न अबाउट द क्राइसिस इवेंट. For us, learn about the available service and support. Again, this is for us. We should know what support we can provide them, because we are going to help. If I tell you what is the synonym of counseling, it is something like help, right? Directively or non-directively we are doing it. We can't counsel at the moment when somebody is in shock, but unconditional positive regard, if we can give, if we can empathize that individual, half of our task done, right? So we should be prepared. If you want to take a break, you want to take a deep breath in, you want to drink lots of water, you want to take something, you just do it. Don't be in hurry, but don't be in delayed also. Itna time na lag jaye ki वो ऑलरेडी परेशान है और परेशान हो जाए इतनी जल्दी, क्योंकि आपको सब डॉक्यूमेंटेड करना है इतनी जल्दी और इतनी ज्यादा। अगर वो कॉपरेट नहीं कर पा रही है, गिव सम टाइम, हैव पेशेंस, डोंट हैव डिले, देन लुक इफ सर्वाइवर इज सेफ और नॉट, जिसके साथ आया है उसके साथ भी सेफ है या नहीं, राइट? यू हैव टू चेक एवरी एस्पेक्ट। सो विद दी सर्वाइवर यू हैव टू काउंसिल द केयर टेकर एज वेल, assess obvious urgent medical need, assess the serious distract reactions, listen, ask about the survivor needs and concern, listen to the survivor and help him to her to feel calm. Link, help survivor address the basic need, assess the services, help survivor cope up with the problem, give information and connect survivor with loved ones and social support. We have to work on resilience, bounce back. Jo hua, we'll work on that, we'll help you with that, but we'll always have the follow one target that this individual is going to work on the results. We have to have the very active understanding. Avoid question why and why not. Don't judge. Is it true, false, anything, but just don't judge. Avoid I know how you feel. Avoid evaluation of their experience and their reaction. Sometimes silence is completely fine. It's not okay to say, let's talk about something else. You should work towards getting over this. You're strong enough to deal with this. You feel better soon. You did everything you could. You need to relax. It's good that you're alive. Concern need to be taken, already explained by ma'am. Process examination in which privacy, it is important to give the victims every right to determine the course of examination. The victim should be given all the rights examined by the professional of the same sex. Survivors should be given the preference to choose any caregiver whom they would like to accompany during the assessment. Their decision must be respected and mental health examination must be accordingly conducted. Rapport formation. To begin interacting with the survivors, especially child, it is important to create safe therapeutic environment where the survivor feel accepted. So we have to be very sensitive while dealing with the and by establishing a rapport with the survivors, because he or she is also a human being, we are also human being. So we have to treat that individual as a human being, not as a machine, and we are also into that human being wala tendency. Interviewing the skill with the survivor, rapport building and interviewing skills are must position of mental health professionals. Maintain the strength and genuineness. Right? You should sound genuine. You should sound ki you are going to help. Hamesha agar hum counseling ki baat karte hain, helping others ki baat karte hain, who is the help giver? We are here to give something. So we are somewhere here. That individual who came to seek the help here. Right? So we have to be genuine. And with that individual, we have so much work, we have so much of pressure, but that moment is for him or her only. Make him or her realize that you are there, everybody is there for him or her only. Inquiry should be done in a gentle manner. You should not be very loud, you should not be very prompt for everything. Genuine, active listening, proper eye contact, proper facial expression. You should not be shocked ki aapke saath kya ho gaya. Right? So we have to be conscious about all those things. Begin the conversation by talking about less threatening subjects. Provide the assurance, safety and confidentiality is very much important. Avoid too much questions. Avoid showing strong emotions such as shock and disbelief. Avoid to try gather all information in one session. Completely fine if you take small breaks. It is completely fine for yourself and for that survivor as well. You always have to say and make that individual feel that rape is never a survivor's fault. That's it. Never hand the survivor a tissue. If you hand a tissue, they will stop crying and keep a box. You can keep a box close by and let them take whenever they need. Because crying is also a kind of ventilation. them ventilate, take a breather, give a relaxation, and then always explain why you are asking certain questions. Try to ask them in a way that can survivor a feeling of control in their recovery. You have to tell them that why you're doing all this thing, why everything asked by you, right? Everything has some rationale. So you have to tell them. Always explain why certain procedure etc. are important, right? It is important, you know that, but that individual might not know, right? So you have to explain. The debriefing is very much important. Let survivor know she or he has a choice. That individual wants to take a rest, like completely fine. If that individual wants someone along with, fine. If that individual wants in privacy, fine. Right? That is her or his call. This is happens when we have to handle the short term and the current situation. But when you find after certain follow-up that no, hires a mental health professional, you can send us to a psychiatric department of ours for a long-term psychological things. If you find depression and chronic anxiety, feeling of vulnerability, loss of control, loss of self-esteem, emotional distress, impaired sense of self, nightmares, self-blame, mistrust, avoidance and post-traumatic stress disorder, chronic mental health disorder, committing suicide and endangering their life. Psychological management, how it is followed? We start with the our case study and we start with our case history and mental status examination. Then we go for the psychological assessment. It can be projective technique, it can be any other things. We can go with the psychological intervention, and then the final target of ours is the rehabilitation of that survivor in personal, social and professional life. Because a child, he will after some time has to go back to school. That is a professional life. Social life is family gathering, friends gathering.